Hi, it's Bor here, and I am excited for this video because I have new information to share about this subwoofer that can help you if you own this sub, are thinking to buy one, or even if you just want to learn more how subs behave overall. Here is the GAS website, and the sub in question is this Alpha Series 15D2. One of the cheapest 15 car subwoofers with about 120 euro price tag. Where that cheap price shows, we will see shortly. What makes me do this video now is this new set of parameters that I got from PLL Electronics via email. Before this new info, parameters that GAS website and some other retailers gave just have been insufficient to calculate any box recommendations. Not just lack of info, but as you can see, these parameters are different from each other. But what that means in practice, I will show after I clarify what these parameters mean. Power handling and impedance are the same for all the sources. This 350 watt RMS power handling is good enough because many cases with this sub you run out of excursion before power handling. Name D2 already reveals that this sub is with dual 2 ohm voice coil. As D is subwoofer sound radiating area, missing that info is not huge deal because it doesn't change much between other similar 15 submodels, but it is nice to have it exact. Voice calls in this new data are measured in parallel. That's how many perhaps are going to connect this up. All data probably is voice calls in series, as shown with this DC resistance. Free air resonance frequency shows that this sub is not for very lows. If you want detailed explanation of WAS and QTS, watch my car versus home speakers video. Lower WAS indicates stiffer suspension and may make sub behave better in smaller enclosures, but higher QTS does opposite. This high QTS basically makes impossible to get flat response, meaning that there are always going to be hump in higher bass region. This 0.39 QTS would be nice, but it's not reality, because it would mean low QES, and that would mean high motor strength, and that is not happening with this magnet. If you know 2 out of 3 of these Q values, you can calculate the last one. But here, with only QTS value, I was left guessing and did not make this video until now. LE is voice coil inductance. Not crucial, it affects higher bass roll off, but nice to have. So, now we have complete dataset, and what makes me more confident to this new data is that it's not flattering. It's what in this price range this size motor would realistically give you. Obviously, I still cannot be 100% sure for this data, but it's best that we got. But the question was what this difference means in practice. Does it matter what parameters you use in your calculations? Here in these bright blue, red and yellow colors is the same 90-liter vented enclosure calculated with these 3 different parameters. So, if you calculated the box using these other retailer parameters, you expected to get this nice and good flat response. But in reality, you got this overpowering 60Hz and this knee for lower bass output. Even though the tuning is down here and the sub can play there. With music, it doesn't sound good when 60 Hz range is booming, and compared to that, the lower bass is lacking. 90 liter seal doesn't make things much better in reality. Also, excursion could be a problem with sealed, and maybe with vented also. I don't know what the Xmax of the sub is. That is one parameter that we are still missing. 1 cm peak-to-peak linear, that is this first line here, can be already good much for this sub, but mechanically it could make more, and probably does. Now, last question remaining, if these parameters make a difference, what kind of box would be best for the subwoofer? Well, that's where the price of this sub shows again. Yes, you get bass, maybe even quite loud in 60 to 70 Hz range, but not much more than that. If you have space and you are willing to make huge boxes, that can make the response better, but also excursion higher. I would not recommend big sealed box. Excursion is just higher and response not that much smoother. If you don't have much amplifier power and are willing to tinker with tuning, this fourth order bandpass could be a fun option. It can make response flatter, but note that the excursion is higher, so you cannot push much power into this, and also it is very big enclosure, so it might not be worth the time and your money. Medium vented maybe is good option for that 350 watts power. If you already have this sub, but don't have space even for the 70 liter box, don't feel bad, just build the box that you can and don't make the board too long. Follow the approximate trend of the board length here and enjoy what you got. Leave a like if you find this video helpful and comment below any questions. If after this you want to learn more about subwoofers, check that car versus home speakers video mentioned earlier. Thanks, bye.